सो आमच्या टीमान प्रोफेशनलच नाही बट आमचे इवन एंड ऑफ द मूवी दे वर मल्टीटास्किंग बिकॉज खूपशे भुरगे दोन दीस असले थोडे चार दीस असले बट स्टील दे मॅनेज टू डू एव्हरीथींग. दुसरी गजाल म्हटल्यार वी हॅड पीपल हू वर्क इन बॉलिवूड सच एज गुंजन सक्सेना हू हॅज डन साऊंड प्रोडक्शन देन बागी सिरीज सेक्शन 375 इवन आमचे जे व्ही एफ एक्स आर्टिस्ट आशिले ही वर्क्स फॉर नागराज मंजुळे सो इट वॉज अ बीग थिंग फॉर अस आणि एक ते नाव दोरपा खातीर एक यु नो गोयचे नाव दोरपा वी हॅड टू बी द बेस्ट सो इट वॉज अ बीग
फिल्म 2018
सिलेक्ट झाले आणि ही वॉज द डी आय ही हॅड डन डी आय फॉर आ फिल्म.
ओके आणि आम्ही पळता म्हणल्यार गोयात खूपशे शूटिंग जाता फिल्माचे बींग अ टुरिस्ट डेस्टिनेशन चडशे फिल्म जाता नॉट ओनली गोवन फिल्म्स बट बॉलिवूड मागीर मराठी तेलुगू मल्याळम खूपशे फिल्म जाता पण आम्ही खंय तरी कोंकणी फिल्माचे जे आमचे तो इम्पॅक्ट असपाक जाय नॅशनल लेवलचा इंटरनॅशनल लेवलचे तो खंय तरी आम्ही फाटी पडटा सो तुका ताजेर कितें म्हणपाचें.
मेन म्हटल्यार कोंकणी फिल्म सध्या आता आय कॅन से स्टार्ट जाता आय वोंट से दॅट आमची फूल इंडस्ट्री सारखी आसा इट वील टेक टायम आणि टू ग्रो दिस कोंकणी इंडस्ट्री फिल्म इंडस्ट्री ऑडियन्स शूड सपोर्ट ऑडियन्स जे आसा दे वॉन्ट यु नो माझे स्वतःचे आयज माझी ॲक्च्युली स्क्रिनींग आसा सो सम ऑफ देम दे वर लायक यु नो फ्री पास मेळटले हे मेळटले ते मेळटले यु नो ते एक स्ट्रगल करना टू कम यु नो फ्रेंडाचे फिल्म आसा लेट्स गो लेट्स पे एन कम ते एक मातशे कमी पळोवपाक मेळटा इवन माझ्या फ्रेंडाचे थोडे फ्रेंड्साचे एक फिचर फिल्म आयिल्ले हालींच सो दे वर लायक आ तुजे फ्रेंडाचे मरे फ्रेंडाचे फिल्म मेळटले सो इट्स दॅट वर्स्ट यु नो सो राईट नाव इन गोवा आय थिंक ऑडियन्स शूड बी द मेन थिंग ऑडियन्स शूड सपोर्ट दीस फिल्म मेकर सो दॅट आणी अशी फिल्मां येतली आणि प्रोड्युसर्स फिल्म प्रोड्यूस करपाक लागतले बिकॉज कितें आता फिल्मा खातीर प्रोड्युसर प्रोड्यूस करता बट यू डोंट गेट इवन हाफ ऑफ इट अँड ड्यू टू वीच ही इंडस्ट्री थंयच आसा यु नो इट हॅज टू ग्रो इट वील टेक टायम.
खरेंच मांगरेशान बरो पॉयंट काढलो की जर आम्ही आमची फिल्म इंडस्ट्री आहात ती वयर काढतले गोवन फिल्म इंडस्ट्री वयर काढतले जर खरं तरी आमचे फ्रेंड्स म्हणतात जे आमचे कोण जे फिल्म मेकर्स असा यंग बडिंग फिल्म मेकर त्यांना सपोर्ट करपाची खरीच गरज असा जो फ्रेंड असू कोणी असू आम्ही एक तिकेट बाय करून जावं एक बारीक बारीक त्यांना प्रोत्साहन देऊन त्यांना पुढे काढपाक जाय. सो मंगरेश हांव जाणा तूं एक प्रोफेशनल डान्सरूय आसा सो यू आर लायक अ पॅकेज लायक अ आर्टिस्ट सो अशें केन्ना की फ्युचरान असो प्लॅन आसा की एक डान्सर म्हणल्यार खंय तरी कोरियोग्राफरी फिल्मिंगान आसा सो कोरियोग्राफी करतलो ऑर एज अ फिल्म मेकरूच तूं फुडें सरतलो.
पयलीं आशिल्लें म्हणजे एक कोरियोग्राफर जातलो म्हणून बट अगेन इवन डान्सर सुद्दां आतां वयर चलता समज इफ यू सी 8-9 years बॅक डान्सांक काय स्कोपूच नासलो इन गोवा एटलीस्ट सो तो एक म्हज्या बॅक ऑफ मायंड आसलो म्हणा लायक वॉट इज द फ्युचर ऑफ डान्सींग बट हांवें तें सोडूंक ना दो आय वॉज डान्सींग बट एक कॅमेरा खातीर एक डिफरंटूच म्हाका एक लायकी आसली सो वीथ दॅट लव फॉर कॅमेरा आय थिंक बिकॉज ऑफ दॅट वी वेंट टू फिल्म मेकींग आय स्टील रिमेंबर वी हॅड डन आवर फर्स्ट फिल्म जी आम्ही आता पळोवपाक सोदिना इट वॉज फर्स्ट फिल्म आमकां कांयच म्हणजे कांयच एक्सपिरियन्स आसना वी जस्ट शॉट वी हॅड अ थीम अँड वी शॉट आमकां एडिटींगेचें कांय खबर नासलें साऊंड म्युझिक कांयच खबर ना कंटिन्युटी कांयच खबर नासली वी जस्ट शॉट द फिल्म आणि जेन्ना पळयले तेन्ना आम्ही बरे प्राऊड असले बट इफ यू टेल मी
टू वॉच
आय कॅन से बट दॅट इज द स्टार्ट बट आय डोंट फील बॅड अबाउट इट लायक कितें केला काय
म्हणून त्या टायमार ते एक
व्हडले असले बट आय विल से दॅट इट्स एन एक्सपिरियन्स अँड आय फील गुड अबाउट इट सो तशी दोन फिल्म आमची एक्सपिरियन्स कशी झाली अँड लकीली फॉर द थर्ड फिल्म वी गॉट टू अवॉर्ड्स सो थंय एक आमकां क्लिक मेळ्ळो आणि दॅट वॉज द मागीर हांवें फाटी पळोवंक ना दॅट वॉज अ बूस्ट फॉर टर्निंग पॉइंट यू कॅन से
मागीर आमी फिल्म्स म्हणटा खुबशे गोंयान आतां आमी पळयतात खुबशे यंग फिल्मेकर्स वयर सरतात पूण खंय तरी एक फ्युचर आमी पळोवंक वचत जाल्यार आमकां दिसता की एक क्वेश्चन मार्क येता खरेंच कितें एक करियर ऑप्शन आसा काय फिल्म मेकिंगान आनी खुबशे भुरगे आसा ते भायर वयता मुंबय वयता पुण्या वयता दिल्ली वयता सो डू यू फील फिल्म मेकींग इज अ करियर म्हणजे गोंयान एक करियर एज अ ऑप्शन चूज करूं शकता भुरगे.
येस डेफिनेटली वाय नॉट इफ दे हॅव द डिटर्मिनेशन टू कंटिन्यू डुईंग यू नो वर्किंग फॉर इट जाता ऑब्वियसली बिकॉज आय फील खंयच्या भुरग्यान खंयच्या न्यू फिल्म मेकरान ही थॉट ऑर शी थॉट दॅट आपूण फिल्म मेकिंग एज अ करियर धरतले इट्स अ रियली गूड थिंग बट दे हॅव टू सी द अदर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑल्सो सच एज हाव वॉट वील बी द रिटर्न्स ओके बिकॉज कितें जाता स्टार्टींग तुका इन रिटर्न तुका कांयच मेळटा दॅट इज देर बट एट दॅट मोमेंट फॅमिली सपोर्ट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट सो फॅमिली सपोर्ट नासल्यार एक मातशें डिफिकल्टी जावंक शकता बट एज एन आर्टिस्ट आय फील खंय ना खंय तरी तुका एक यु नो एक जैत मेळटलें बट इट वील टेक टायम
स्टार्टींग
एन्ड आय फील एन्ड आय फील जे कितें तुगे रिसोर्सीस आसा न्ही म्हणजे एक कॅमेरा जो कितें जावं यू कॅन डू अ फिल्म ऑन दॅट आतां बारीक बारीक भुरगे
बीजेपीचे एकच दायज
माधवची बदलली वाट
गोयचा विश्वासघात
माधवची बदलली वाट गोयचा विश्वासघात
गोयकारांची लागली
माधवची बदलली वाट
गोयकारांची लागली वाट
माधवची बदलली वाट
गोयकारांची लागली वाट
माधवची बदलली वाट
गोयकारांची लागली वाट
बीजेपीचे एकच दायज
गोयचा इंटरेस्ट कॉम्प्रोमाइज
बीजेपीचे एकच दायज
गोयचा इंटरेस्ट कॉम्प्रोमाइज
राहुल सर कॅन यू टेल अस व्हाय यू आर प्रोटेस्टिंग टुडे
हे एकूच प्लेकार्ड सांगता सगळे पॉपट सवन सोल्ड माधय काल पराजे दिसा गोयचो जो वकील आसलो सरकार तर्फे ताणे स्टेटमेंट केलो की सावंताचे इन्स्ट्रक्शन म्हणून आपले फुडें अपिलाक वचूना म्हणून तेन्ना अशी फट उगड जाली जो सावंत सांगतालो तो एडवोकेट आपल्या प्रमाणे केले ही सारखी फट जी आसली ती एडवोकेट दातारान उगड केली तेन्ना अशें दिसून येता सावंतान गोयचो इंट्रस्ट कॉम्प्रोमाइज केलो गोंयकारांचो इंट्रस्ट कॉम्प्रोमाइज केलो आमी सदांच सांगता हो सावंत जो आसा हो मुखेलमंत्री गोंयचो हो बीजेपीचे हायकमांडे फक्त आयकता तो सांगताचे वागता म्हणून हे प्लेकार्ड आसा पपेट सावंत सोल्ड माधय हे सगळे उद्दिश्ट आसा सावंत सरकारान माधयचो इंट्रस्ट जो आसा सगळो कर्नाटकाक दिल्लो आसा कर्नाटक विकलो आनी काल जे 300 कोटी जे आयल्या तो एक खंय तरी कॉम्पन्सेशन दिला आमी गोंयकार इतले लाचार ना हो 300 कोटी घेवपाक हो कॉम्पन्सेशन जो दिला सेंट्रल सरकारान गोंयकारांचे म्हादय काढून जे विकल्या कर्नाटकाक ते आमी कदापि स्विकार करना हे सावंताक आमी मुद्दाम सांगून आयिल्ल्या सांगा
आयज ह्या दिसांनी सुद्दां म्हणजे नॉर्मली मे
म्हयन्यान बी आमकां गोंयकारांक खंय तरी उदकाचे मातशे त्रास जाताले, पूण आयज आमकां जानेवारी म्हयन्यान सुद्दां जेन्ना उदकाचो त्रास जावपाक लागलो तेन्ना आमकां समजून येता की हो कित्याक जावपाक लागलो. आमची म्हादय, आमची जी न्हंय आसा, मेजर जे उदकाचो सोर्स आसा, त्या उदकाचो सोर्स कंप्लिटली कर्नाटकान कायद्याच्या विरोधान वचून वाट बदललेली आसा, आनी ताज्या खातीर आज गोंयकार सफर जाता. हाज्या मुखार आमची कितें पाळी येतली उदका खातीर हें आमकां खबर ना. म्हणून आयज आमी आमच्या सीएमाक, गोंयचो जो सीएम आसा, जाणें आमच्या गोंयचो इंट्रेस्ट 300 कोट्या खातीर आमकां दिसता खंय विकिल्लो आसा, ताका सांगपाक आयला की ताणें विचार करचो, गोंयकारांचो इंट्रेस्ट सांबाळचो.
आमी पयलींच्यान सांगत आयल्या की ह्या सरकाराक, बीजेपी सरकाराक गोंयाचे कांयच पडलेले ना, आनी म्हादयचे तर मात्तूय पडलेले ना. बीजेपीन आमची म्हादय, आमची आवय पावणेर काडल्या हे आमी सदांच सांगत आयल्या, आनी त्या पावणेची रक्कम पयर बीजेपी सरकाराक 300 कोटी केंद्र सरकारान दिल्या, एनाउंस केल्या. आनी हे आमी प्रमोद सावंताक आज मुद्दम सांगपाक आयल्या की आमी आमची म्हादय पावणेर काडपाक दिवपाक ना. गोंयकार आपल्या म्हादय खातीर सदांच झगडटले. आम आदमी पार्टी म्हादयच्या फाटल्यान सदांच उबी रावतली, आनी आमची म्हादय पावणेर काडपाक आमी केन्नाच दिवपाक ना. दुसरें, प्रमोद सावंतान पपेट सावंत जावपाचे बंद करचे, खाम सुत्री बावली जावपाची बंद करचे, की केंद्र सरकार थंय बीजेपीचे हायकमांड बसता आनी ते सांगता तशें तो वागता, हे आतां बंद जावपाक जाय. कारण तुमी म्हादयचेर कॉम्प्रोमायज केला, हे आतां सगळ्या गोंयकारांक उक्ताडार आयला. त्या खातीर आमी सांगता पपेट सावंताक की बंद कर, बीजेपीचे हायकमांडाचे आयकपाचे बंद कर, गोंयकारां खातीर काम करपाक लागा, ना जाल्यार आम आदमी पार्टी जसो हो प्रोटेस्ट करता तसो प्रोटेस्ट तुमकां गोंयभर पळोवपाक मेळटलो. कारण सगळे गोंयकार म्हादय कॉम्प्रोमायज करपाक दिवपाक ना, म्हादय खातीर सगळे गोंयकार एकठांय जातले.
म्हादय, 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 म्हादय,
म्हादय, म्हादय,
म्हादयची बदलली वाट,
गोंयकारांची लायली वाट,
म्हादयची बदलली वाट,
गोंयकारांची लायली वाट,
म्हादयची बदलली वाट,
गोंयकारांची लायली वाट.
बीजेपीचे एकच दायज
गोंयचो इंटरेस्ट कॉम्प्रोमाइज,
बीजेपीचे एकच दायज
गोंयचो इंटरेस्ट कॉम्प्रोमाइज,
बीजेपीचे एकच दायज
गोंयचो इंटरेस्ट कॉम्प्रोमाइज,
बीजेपीचे एकच दायज
गोंयचो इंटरेस्ट कॉम्प्रोमाइज.
म्हादयची बदलली वाट,
गोंयकारांची लायली वाट,
म्हादयची बदलली वाट,
गोंयकारांची लायली वाट.
म्हादय फर्स्ट थिंग तशेंच झाला आनी एका मागीर हळूहळू आनी
Water Resources brings to you Goa and Sip, Goa's finest premium packaged drinking water, bottled at the source, untouched and pure.
Park Prime Goa, a boutique hotel on banks of River Mandovi, Old Pato Beach, Panjim. There are three categories of spacious and luxurious rooms that are elite, executive and suites. Each of the rooms and suites have rain shower and all modern gadgets and amenities. Overview of River Mandovi and Atal Setu. For fine dining, the property has tulip restaurants with combination of relaxed ambience and informal modern design with enjoyable dining experience. The restaurant serves both vegetarian and non-vegetarian delicacy cuisine prepared from the choices of ingredients to satisfy any palate. Visit us today at Park Prime Goa near Old Pato Bridge opposite PWD Colony Pato Panjim. Or contact us on 9188872734.
So, zara apni strengths or weaknesses bataiye.
My strengths are my biceps, my triceps, my shoulders. Abs thode weak hai.
Iski job to nahi lagegi, par aapki lage to branded premium fog master lagana. Job laga, fog laga.
To young man, apne bare mein kuch bataiye.
सर मेरी छोड़िए, आप अपनी बताइए.
अरे मैं तो
व्हाट
व्हाट
इसकी जॉब तो नहीं लगेगी, पर आपकी लगे तो ब्रांडेड प्रीमियम फॉग मास्टर लगाना. जॉब लगा, फॉग लगा.
आमच्या वांगडा आता शिवर या फिल्माचे प्रोडक्शन टीम असा. माझ्या वांगडा असा अनूप आरोलकर, तसेच जेनिस डिसुजा. अनूप हो एक डान्सरूय असा आणि ताणेन फिल्मान प्रोडक्शनान काम केला. सो जाणून घ्या त्यांचा एक्सपिरियन्स कसा आसला तो. सो अनूप, तुझा एक्सपिरियन्स कसा आसलो शिवर या फिल्माचे काम करता असताना?
एक्सपिरियन्स म्हटल्यार इट वॉज रिअली चॅलेंजिंग. ओके, बिकॉज तुका तो टायम असता 4 दीस अँड यू हॅव टू डू एव्हरीथिंग, मॅनेज एव्हरीथिंग. सो त्या 4 दिसांनी जे आम्ही काम केले, लाईक नॉट ओनली मी, लाईक सगळ्यांनी, लाईक फूल प्रोडक्शन टीमान असलेले, लाईक मल्टीटास्किंग करप त्या मोमेंटाक बी, इट वॉज लाईक रिअली चॅलेंजिंग, बट एट द सेम टाईम इट वॉज फन. इतली मजा येता बिकॉज ती मजा ती 4 दिसां खातीर असता काम करपाची. म्हणजे लास्ट मोमेंट सगळे अरेंज करप, कितें असं मेळटलें, जपकूर कितें मात तुका अरेंज करचें पडलें, सगळें फूल सेट तुका चेंज करचो पडलो, त्या टायमान तुका सेट चेंज करप, यू नो, इट्स अ हेडेक. एट द सेम टायम मजा, चॅलेंजींग, खूब मजा येता करपा खातीर. की लास्ट मोमेंट तुका गडबडीन सगळें तें करप, एट द सेम टायम तो सारके त्या म्हणजे जो हे तुझ्या डिरेक्टराक जाय, जो हो सेटअप तुका जाय कसो केलेलो,
विज्युअलाईज केला तसे
तसेच. हा, करप इज लाईक इट्स व्हेरी चॅलेंजींग, एट द सेम टायम व्हेरी फन. इट्स रियली गुड.
हांव तुका जे हांवें मंगेशाक विचारलें तेच तुका परत विचारूंक सोदता. शिवर म्हटल्यार मुवी जे आहा ते टोटली म्हाका दिसता रेन हितूंतल्यान शूट जाला. सो बिंग इन अ प्रोडक्शन तुका कितले चॅलेंजींग आसलेले, म्हणल्यार पावस आणि ते सगळे मॅनेज करप?
चॅलेंजींग म्हटल्यार असले चॅलेंजींग तसे खूप. म्हणजे लास्ट मोमेंट, लाईक आम्ही आता थंयसर जे आम्ही शूट करताले तर वयर फूल आम्ही थंय पावडर बी घातलेलो, सो दॅट लायटींग बरी जावपा खातीर. मागीर थंय आम्ही स्पेशली आम्ही एक वॉटर टँक आफयल्लो आणि आम्ही थंय उदक घातलेले थ्रू पायप्स एंड ऑल, यू नो. सो ते त्या टायमार तसो म्हणजे तो सीन क्रिएट करपा खातीर तितलोच पावस जाय तुका, चड पडप करना, कमी पडप करना, चड उदक पडप करना, तितलेंच उदक पडपाक जाय, तेका होस लावन सगळें घालपाक जाय, बायच्यांक उदक काडपाक जाय सगळें. सो दॅट वॉज लायक अ इट वॉज गूड एक्सपिरियन्स, यू नो. लायक एक्चुली आमकां तो खबर नासलें पयलीं, हेज्या पयलीं आमकां नासलें खबर की आमी कशें करतले ते. सो मागीर ते रिसर्च करप, बाबा कशें करपाचें ते, वचून सगळें आयडियाक घेवप आनी ते लास्ट मोमेंट एक्सपिरिमेंट करप, थंयसर त्याच मोमेंटाक एक्सपिरिमेंट करप आनी त्या टायमा भितर तो एक्सपिरिमेंट करून तो तसोच हाडून देव सारको, तितलोच पावस, तितलोच उदक सगळ्याक घालप. सो आय फील इट वॉज रियली गूड, इट वॉज रियली 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 गूड.
सो अनुपान जसे सांगले तसे मांगुरी सांडेच्या टिमीन खूप एफर्ट्स घेतले फिल्म करपाक आणि आता त्यांचे फिल्म या वर्षा इफ्फीक सिलेक्ट झाला. सो खरेच त्यांची टोकनाय करपासारखी असा. आणि आता माझ्या वांगडा असा जेनिस डिसुजा, ज्याने बिहाइंड द सीन्स तसेच कंटिन्युटी जी असता फिल्मान ताजेर त्याने काम केला. सो ताजो एक्सपिरियन्स आम्ही जाणून घेऊया. सो जेनिस, तुझं कसा आसलो एक्सपिरियन्स आणि बिंग इन अ कॉलेज तुवें या फिल्माचे काम केला, सो कसा आसलो एक्सपिरियन्स तुझा?
एक्सपिरियन्स खूब बरो आसलो, कारण लायक दीस वॉज द फस्ट टायम आय वर्क ऑन अ लार्जर स्केल फिल्म एज कम्पेर्ड टू द शॉर्ट फिल्म दॅट वी हॅव डन इन कॉलेज. अँड लायक इट इट वॉज अ व्हेरी, यू कूड लर्न अ लॉट बिकॉज दे वर फ्यू पीपल हू आर लायक प्रोफेशनल्स हू इन द इंडस्ट्री प्रॉपरली, सो यू कूड लर्न अ लॉट फ्रॉम दॅम. बिसाइड्स लायक इवन इफ यू मेड मिस्टेक्स यू न्यू दॅट देर आर पीपल हू विल कवर अप टेक केअर अँड मांगरीश इज लाईक व्हेरी सपोर्टिव्ह अँड ही वॉज व्हेरी ही डजंट गेट पिस्ड ऑफ दॅट इझिली लकी सो ही हॅज गायडेड मी थ्रूआउट द शॉर्ट फिल्म लाईक हाऊ टू टेक द कंटिन्युटी अँड एव्हरीथिंग सो या इट वॉज अ व्हेरी गुड एक्सपिरियन्स अँड इवन दो लाईक सर्टन टाईम्स द कंटिन्युटी वूड गेट लाईक दे वर मिस्टेक्स बिकॉज द ॲक्टर्स अनोईंगली दे वूड चेंज समथिंग ओर टच द फेस ओर द मेकअप वूड हॅव गॉन देन इवन द स्मॉल बॉय his hair had to be kept in that way only because at one strand would come this side and then the next continuity you would come to know
so it was quite challenging
so I had to make sure that I had to keep clicking pictures of every cut that he took yeah
so it was basically a learning experience for you yeah
yes
okay so kharet bare disle mangirish ani tyaje team engda ulon आम्ही याच्या फुडें तुमच्या मुखार आनीक फिल्ममेकर्स जे आसा त्यांचे इंटरव्यूज घेऊन येतले सो टील देन पळयत रावात प्राईम
हर सुबह ब्यूटीफुल दिखने के लिए चेहरे पर निखार और इवन टोन जरूरी है निखार के साथ मॉइस्चराइजेशन भी जरूरी है
आपकी हर जरूरत को पूरा करे व्हाइट टोन सॉफ्ट एंड स्मूथ क्रीम जरा सा लगाते ही चेहरे को मिले ऑयल फ्री लुक इवन टोन और खिला खिला निखार व्हाइट टोन सॉफ्ट एंड स्मूथ क्रीम
हर सुबह ब्यूटीफुल दिखने के लिए चेहरे पर निखार और इवन टोन जरूरी है निखार के साथ मॉइस्चराइजेशन भी जरूरी है
आपकी हर जरूरत को पूरा करे व्हाइट टोन सॉफ्ट एंड स्मूथ क्रीम जरा सा लगाते ही चेहरे को मिले ऑयल फ्री लुक इवन टोन और खिला खिला निखार व्हाइट टोन सॉफ्ट एंड स्मूथ क्रीम
We are hiring account executive full time for 3-star resort in Vagathore. Minimum 3 years experience should have knowledge of tally. Experience will be preferred. Contact us on 7219894299 or email us at alcovegoa@yahoo.in.
Alcove Beach Resort. With a pleasant view of the Arabian Sea and the small Vagathore beach, offering luxuriously designed sea view suite rooms, penthouses, additionally eco-friendly cottages which are inclusive of living room, bedrooms, suites with pool view, standard rooms and cottages. You name it and we have it all. Enjoy a hassle-free holiday at Alcove Beach Resort. Come, be our guest. In order to tickle your taste buds, we have continental, Goan, Portuguese, Indian, Chinese and Thai cuisine with luxurious fine dining which can be experienced with the majestic hues of the sunset. Our address is Alcove Beach Resort, Ozran Beach, Small Vagathore, Anjuna, Goa. For details, contact 227-4491. Casa Marcus, an exclusive furniture mall with imported furniture, furnishing and artifacts from southeast regions of Asia, made of redwood, oakwood, walnut and ash wood. Right from bedroom furniture to dining tables and exclusive chairs, indoor and outdoor, and garden furniture, durable to sustain the humid and tropical climate of Goa. Also, we offer contemporary furniture, vintage, antique furniture, lighting, water fountains, and furnishings such as curtains, bed sheets, pillows, mattresses are also available and are solely imported and custom cleared. For details, contact 8079-442286. The Baga Deck. Lies in the comfort with unmatched luxury, the bluest of skies melt seamlessly into the azure of the Arabian Sea to make a picture-perfect backdrop to a unique, tailor-made tropical holiday experience. Come, join us at the Baga Tech Comforts, Cobra Wado, opposite Subway, Kalangut Baga Road, Kalangut Bades, Goa. For details, contact 2976041-9823-619910. The Kandolim Deck. Come dine with us and enjoy Goa's best hospitality service. Enjoy a very delicious cuisine, North Indian, Goan, Continental, Chinese, you name it and we have it all. Visit us at Wadi Sikeri Road, Kandolim, Goa. Contact 2479040 or 9822580138.
Gems of Goa Season 2. I'm Alicia Fernandez, and in this episode of Gems of Goa Season 2, we have with us a singing sensation, somebody who began singing at a very young age. We have with us none other than Akshada Bandekar.
Hi Alicia, and hello to everybody watching. Thank you so much for having me, and I'm really excited to be here.
Yeah, Akshada, we are also so excited to have you finally after a long yes and no's and a lot of fixing of appointments, and finally this thing has happened today. So we are very finally glad to have you on the show.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, so Akshada, to begin with, if you could just tell us about how did your journey begin in this particular field?
So, you know, I've been singing since I was probably yay high. And ever since I can remember, music has just always been a part of my life. In fact, if you ask my mom this question, you'll get like a never-ending story of how it all began. But just to sort of quote her, you know, she always used to talk about how when I was a baby and in my cradle, she could never not leave the radio on. So every single moment that the radio was off, I'd get super cranky and I'd start crying and, you know, it'll be really difficult to handle me. So she used to just keep the radio on and I'd just be this really obedient, quiet baby listening to the songs. And so I guess that's how the whole musical atmosphere was always created around me. And at the time, you know, the only radio that was very prominent was AIR, All India Radio. So, and they used to play like different kinds of songs at different times of day. So I got like a taste of all the different genres and different languages from a very young age. So I guess that's how it all started.
Exactly. It was something which began at a very young age for you. Also, if when we have a closer look at your entire profile and your entire portfolio, in that also it has been mentioned that you have been working for the society very closely from a very young age. One of the perfect examples was in 2005. So if you could just elaborate more and tell us about that particular concert which you took place in 2005.
So in terms of performing, if I just, you know, take it a bit back, I started going up on stage. My first performance on stage was when I was 3 years old. And that's actually an interesting story. There was a New Year party happening in my colony, and I was not even part of the list of performers. But when I was sitting there in the audience watching everyone perform, I just felt that urge to, you know, to go up on stage as well and perform. And I did that at three. I sang a complete 3-paragraph long song. And even though I wasn't part of the lineup, I won. And that was like a big, like a morale booster for me. And I felt so wonderful. And I was like, I want to perform more. And, you know, that's how I continued performing at competitions all over Goa. And talking about my first concert, you know, back then my mom had this habit of reading out newspaper articles to me. You know, she really inculcated a lot of good habits in me from a young age. And she used to, when the tsunami hit, I wasn't even aware of what exactly it was, what was the devastation that happened. But as she was reading it out to me, the one thing that I picked up on was that all these, you know, famous musical artists and singers, they were performing and having concerts in aid of these, you know, victims and people who are affected by it. So I was curious and I just asked my mom, what is this all about? And then she explained it to me. And I just felt that was a very wonderful way for me to combine and use my music, you know, and sing my concerts and do something good with it. So that's how it all started. I just brought up the idea to my parents and they were really happy. They were very supportive. And that's how I started going up on that journey. And through that concert, I, you know, donated all the proceeds that I got to the Prime Minister's Relief Fund. And I felt really good after that. And that's when I decided I'll continue to keep doing this for the rest of my life.
Which is indeed commendable, because at that age, having that entire idea of, you know, performing on the stage, like you said, you began at the age of 3. So a lot of people at that particular age, or for that matter till now, have this something called stage fright. So was that in any way affecting you, or did you have any stage fright, or it was like, no, this is my ground, I'm here to perform and I'm here to just be there and just be myself? What was it like for you?
Actually, it's the opposite for me. You know, whenever I feel afraid or anxious or stressed out, I just want to perform, because that is like my stress buster. I love performing. Wow. I love being up on stage. As soon as, you know, it doesn't matter what I've been through the whole day. It doesn't matter who's in the crowd. I just go up there and I have a good time. And when I see people join in, when I see them enjoy, it really makes me feel good. So it's the opposite for me. It's a stress buster for me.
But now that you have been like in this field for quite some time, and people have seen you, and you know, they have said that, you know, you are a child sensation, and you have been one of those people who have been like a role model for a lot of people, the expectations of people maybe keep increasing day by day. So how are you dealing with this entire thing, and what is it like for you, wherein, you know, people have this thing, no, that you're a child prodigy and you must have done something really amazing at a very young age, and then, you know, you have to do something, like you have to perform. Is there any kind of performance pressure for you?
Not really, you know. I've never really looked at it from that point of view. I'm just really lucky to have gotten, you know, so many well wishes and people to support me from a young age. And about being a role model, I don't know. I just try to do whatever I do to the best of my ability. I'm very true to my art. I love to perform. I love to make people feel good through my music. So that's just the main, you know, reason for me to continue to push me to put out more songs and more concerts. So yeah.
Which is lovely. Also, you have won the National Child Award for your exceptional achievement in singing and individual contribution to the society. So how was that feeling when you received the award from the president then?
That was so ecstatic, to be honest. It was in 2012, so it was probably 14. I was 14, yeah. And it was during Diwali. It was a wonderful Diwali present for me. And I remember everyone in the house was so excited. We're going to the Rashtrapati Bhavan. It's a big honor, right? So we kind of did all our Diwali rituals, and, you know, we finished with all that and we took a late night flight. We head to Delhi. And as I was landing, I could see all these people celebrating and all the fireworks. It was really like adding on to my excitement. You know, it felt like a true celebration. And then the whole experience, right from waking up in the morning that day and then traveling to that beautiful, you know, Rashtrapati Bhavan, entering, and it was just a wonderful experience. I don't know. I don't know how to put it into words, but it was wonderful. And definitely it motivated me to, you know, really be worthy of that title for the rest of my life. And that's what I will always have in the back of my mind.
which is really amazing. Also, if I may ask you, right now, this entire COVID pandemic has, you know, changed people's life in many ways. So has it affected you in any way, especially with your singing or with, you know, the entire being? How are you dealing with this entire thing?
So the thing is, this actually last year, I'm still stuck in 2020. In 2020, I graduated from college. And, you know, what I had decided was, as soon as I graduate, I'm going to really get more into performing live, because that I hadn't been doing that for a long time, because I was studying and I was really busy with academics. But the plan was that this year, I'm really going to get into music. I'm going to perform a lot. But of course, we all know how, you know, 2020 worked out to be. So yeah. in terms of it affecting me, I think it just was similar to what everybody else experienced, you know, a lot of isolation, a lot of introspection, initial anxiety, apprehension, you don't know what's going to happen, right? So what I did was I just looked towards my music. I continued to write songs. I continued to listen to music. And basically, that was all that was going on in my mind. In fact, during the lockdown, I put out 3 songs, original songs on my YouTube. One was White Coat Superheroes, which I wrote for all our doctors, nurses, and healthcare workers that were on the front lines, that are still on the front lines. COVID warriors, right? So that was kind of my ode to what they were doing for us. Another one was Love and Light, which is just an acoustic song that I wrote on my guitar to just send out love and light into the world for anyone who is feeling alone, anyone who has been directly affected by the pandemic. You know, a lot of people have had varied levels of being affected by this. And that is what I just wanted to put out through that song. And yeah, I basically just continued to write since I wasn't able to perform a lot.
Which I think you'd also have done one album, which you came up with a music video, which you came up with of the Christmas related, which was released by the minister himself. So how was that feeling for you?
That was, again, every time I write a song, every time I complete a song and I put it out for people to listen to, I think that is the reward in itself. The whole process of beginning to write and then getting a finished product, it's
and
very interesting.
You have done, but especially also in 2019, also you have done, right? A song on Christmas?
In 2018, yes. So that one was called A Christmas Song. And this one is called Merry Christmas 2020. So the idea behind this song was, a lot of people, ever since the beginning of the year, 2020, they were talking about how they just want this year to go by real quickly, and they just want to celebrate Christmas and New Year and be done with it, right? And that was like the sentiment that was being echoed all throughout the year, all over the internet, people on Twitter and whatnot. So that was kind of always in the back of my mind. And I was like, now that it's finally Christmas, I have to put out a song. I have to do something and really just get back that spirit and that hope going into the New Year. So that was basically the idea behind the song. And you know, every time that I play it for someone, and the response has been really wonderful. So that's been nice.
That's, I think, wonderful. Well, on that note, we're going to take a short break. On the other side of the break, we still have Akshata. So we'll be discussing more about her life on the other side of this break. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.
DJ Godwin Goa brings to you the exclusive wedding package. Includes DJ, one-man band, pulsating 2PA sound, female compare, the exclusive rate of just 26,000. Book before offer closes. Call 9422452821.
Welcome back to Conversation with Akshata Bandekar, the singer, the singing sensation, and somebody who has been also composing music and whatnot. Akshata, welcome back.
Thank you so much.
Akshata, to begin with, if I could ask you now, with regard to, we have discussed about your journey. So if now we discuss about the other side of it, like you come from a very well-educated family, and you have, I could say you have different professions in your family, be it a doctor, be it engineer. So was there any kind of pressure for you? Like, you know, you'd also need to opt for a career like that and, you know, try to push in music to maybe a secondary option or a hobby kind of?
Oh, no, no, not at all. In fact, it was my mother who noticed my passion for music from a young age and began supporting me. I mean, the only reason that I have this portfolio from a young age, you know, and the only reason that I have all these concerts and the fact that I make these songs is because of my mom and because of my dad. Because if they hadn't supported me every step of the way, you know, it wouldn't have been possible. I remember when I was, I mean, when you're a six-year-old, imagine a six-year-old coming up to you and saying, I want to do a benefit concert for victims of the tsunami victims, right? So, I mean, saying yes to that and being fully supportive of that, it's incredible. And I think just for me, I'm also an engineer now. I have my Bachelor of Engineering in electronics. True. I think for me growing up, you know, watching them lead by example and be so amazing, I just always had that within me that I want to be like them. I just want to, like, even if I'm half as good as my parents, I think I'll be, you know, happy. So, and besides, engineering is something that I also am very interested in. The whole world kind of revolves around all these technological innovations and all the new kind of stuff that people innovate. And I really wanted to be a part of that industry. So, and I had the aptitude for it, so I went for it, you know. And I remember when I was in high school, I came across this article where they spoke about how engineering principles and technology can be integrated into music to create like the next generation of tools for music making. And I was like, this is really interesting. So at that point, I was like, I'm doing engineering. That's it.
So basically, you found something which has a relation with music.
Definitely, yeah. I mean, if you look at how much the music industry has grown, you know, all our old Bollywood songs, the beautiful Bollywood songs from the 60s, 70s era, the way they used to record, you know, in one shot with the orchestra and with the singer present in the room at the same time, compared to now it's like you create a track on a computer or you know, a live musician will play it, and then that's you can great. Come in anytime, sing your vocals, mm-hmm. chop it up, do whatever you want, you know. So there's a lot of technological integration into the music world, and I really want to explore that. So I'm excited for the future.
Which is lovely. Also, if like I said just now, you know, it is very important for a family, or for that matter, you know, your society, or for that matter, relatives, to support you in this kind of a profession. So how important it is, you would put it into in category of, you know, say about from 0 to 100%, how important is it for parents to support their children and to understand that their child is good at this particular initiative of or this particular profession?
Right. You asked me 0 to 100%. I'm going to say 200%. It is the most important thing to have, you know, that support and that pillar of strength. Because when you have that in your roots, you can really go out, reach out and put your hands out into the world and really do whatever it is that you want to do with full confidence. You know, I remember growing up, you know, as teenagers and whatever, we have these moments of self-doubt. You know, we keep asking ourselves, can we do this? Are we good enough? And when you have someone else, especially your parents, tell you, reinforce that, yes, you are good enough, you can do this, and they have that confidence in you even when you don't at times, I think that is very essential to be able
basically
to
basically throwing you the direction
out. Exactly, yeah. So I think it is definitely very important, and people who have that are very lucky.
Indeed, definitely. Also, Akshada, if I may put it to you, a question which a lot of people have in their minds, when, you know, you get a lot of fame or a lot of, a lot of applause at a very young age, how are you, like, you know, do you think in any way that you somehow missed the actual childhood, or because you started, like, you know, at a very young age, or you feel like, you know, you have enjoyed both, that you have enjoyed your childhood also, and at the same time you have also worked for the society? How do you see it?
Yeah, I have definitely had the best of both worlds. I think, you know, I have been balancing my musical extracurricular activities and my academics forever, I think, for as long as I can remember. And I don't think going forward with my life, I will ever be able to have just one of these things. I will always keep doing something in my academics and keep simultaneously doing something in my music. So no, I haven't, you know, I've enjoyed my childhood. And when you talk about, like, getting applause and a lot of appreciation, that is just, like they say, you know, it is just a byproduct of what you do. Basically, the main thing is your action and what you're doing. So you have to really focus on that. And getting all the support and everything, that is a result of, you know, what you contribute to the world. So that is how I look at it. And, you know, that just pushes away anything negative.
I think the perspective that you put it in is one of the best ways so people should look into. Well, on that note, we're going to take another short break. On the other side of the break, we're going to have the rapid fire round. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Alcove Beach Resort, with a pleasant view of the Arabian Sea and the small Vagatol Beach, offering luxuriously designed sea view suit room.
Welcome back from 0 to 100%. How important is it for parents to support their children and to understand that their child is good at this particular initiative of or this particular profession?
Right. You asked me 0 to 100%. I'm going to say 200%. It is the most important thing to have, you know, that support and that pillar of strength. Because when you have that in your roots, you can really go out, reach out and put your hands out into the world and really do whatever it is that you want to do with full confidence. You know, I remember growing up, you know, in, as teenagers and whatever, we have these moments of self-doubt. You know, we keep asking ourselves, can we do this? Are we good enough? And when you have someone else, especially your parents, tell you, reinforce that yes, you are good enough, you can do this, and they have that confidence in you even when you don't at times, I think that is very essential to be able
basically
to
basically throwing you the direction.
Exactly. Yeah, so I think it is definitely very important, and people who have that are very lucky.
Indeed, definitely. Also, Akshada, if I may put it to you a question which a lot of people have in their minds. When, you know, you get a lot of fame or a lot of, a lot of applause at a very young age. How are you like, you know, do you think in any way that you somehow missed the actual childhood? Or because you started like, you know, at a very young age, or you feel like, you know, you have enjoyed both, that you have enjoyed your childhood also, and at the same time, you have also worked for the society. How do you see it?
Yeah, I have definitely had the best of both worlds. I think, you know, I have been balancing my musical extracurricular activities and my academics forever, I think, for as long as I can remember. And I don't think going forward with my life, I will ever be able to have just one of these things. I will always keep doing something in my academics and keep simultaneously doing something in my music. So no, I haven't, you know, I've enjoyed my childhood. And when you talk about like getting applause and a lot of appreciation, that is just, like they say, you know, it is just a byproduct of what you do. Basically, the main thing is your action and what you're doing. So you have to really focus on that. And getting all the support and everything, that is a result of, you know, what you contribute to the world. So that is how I look at it. And, you know, that just pushes away anything negative.
I think the perspective that you put it in is one of the best ways so people should look into. Well, on that note, we're going to take another short break. On the other side of the break, we're going to have the rapid fire round. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. Welcome back. We are in conversation with Akshada Bandekar. Akshada, now this is the segment which people love watching and is the most awaited segment of Gems of Goa. So in this particular rapid fire round, I'm going to ask you a couple of questions. So you need to brace yourself as we're going to begin the rapid fire round. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm excited.
Okay, so let's begin the rapid fire rounds of Gems of Goa season 2. So very quickly then, what is the one thing that you would put on your bucket list?
I think going to space, because I'm obsessed with space and I'm kind of a wimp about it. I think just walking to the spaceship, I'd kind of fall unconscious halfway, but I just really like space and I'm very interested in like being up there. I don't know if it'll happen, but it's on my bucket list. Probably one of the last things
Interesting. Okay. The first question went quite interesting. Okay, let's go ahead to the next one then. Okay, when you're not working, how do you spend your time?
Oh, with my cats. I can while away hours with my cats. I have 3 cats, Snowy, Snowbell, and Ashley, all with unique and different personalities. So I've become a cat when I'm with them. So it's really, I forget about time.
Which is so sweet. Okay. So what's one of your favorite summer activity?
Summer activity, sitting in front of the AC in my room. The summers here are very hot. So it's like my favorite background activity. All the other activities happen, you know, in the cold atmosphere, because otherwise it gets really hot.
Okay.
I'm trying to be as rapid as I can, so my answers might get a little weird.
No, we are loving it. So far, so good. We are loving all of them. Okay. Answer one word for the following. What's your favorite word?
Mom.
Mom. Okay.
I say it all the time.
Okay. Your 20s?
My 20s. I have just started. And I'm excited and I hope I get really adventurous in my 20s.
Okay. Music?
Oh, music. Passion, love, life, stress buster, like I said.
Okay. Family?
My everything.
Okay. Society? One word.
Interesting.
Okay. Okay. COVID-19 pandemic.
Bad.
Okay. Okay. Very quickly then, describe yourself in 3 words.
Okay. I am very curious. I am imaginative. And I am optimistic.
Okay. So are you a morning person or a night person? What do you like more?
I'm actually both, which is not a nice thing, which means I don't get enough sleep.
Okay.
But I think I lean more towards being a morning person. I like it when my day starts early.
Okay. What's the food that you dislike the most?
Ooh, I've been a poor eater right from my childhood, and I've always been bad with like having my veggies and stuff. But I'm trying to get better now. So I guess, I don't know, I don't want to be like a bad influence. Vegetables are good. All kids watching this should eat their vegetables. I don't know. I don't like tomatoes. I love ketchup, but I don't like eating like raw tomatoes.
Okay. So what's your best weapon?
My best weapon? My best weapon. Weapon sounds too dangerous. Like, what would I do with a weapon?
Any kind of weapon that you have with you, or, you know, any kind of thing that you have, maybe your personality-wise, your hobby-wise, which you would consider as your best weapon against others.
Against others. So that's such a negative way to look at it. I guess, you know, whenever I have like my friends over and stuff, if my cats are with me, they kind of get scared to sit around, you know, because of the claws. So I guess my cats are my weapon. I don't know.
Oh.
They're very protective of me. So they're very protective of me. So anyone, you know, tries to pet them or, you know, tries to do anything weird, they just come in. Wow.
I think you did amazing in your maiden rapid fire round at Gems of Goa season 2.
It was so much fun. I was kind of nervous about this part of the show. I was like thinking about it last night. What is she going to ask me?
Well, it is amazing the way you answered. You were very spontaneous. And I think this is something which we always want in any rapid fire round of ours. So I think it is one of the most interesting ones so far.
Thank you so much.
Well, Akshata, before you leave, I want you to, give a particular message to all your viewers and all the fans of yours who have become a part of your, your followers ever since like maybe 3 years and now who have been following you, because you have become somehow or the other, you have become an influential person and people are following you. People are looking at you as a role model now. So any particular message that you would like to give to them? Go ahead.
Oh, wow. Okay, first of all, thank you so much for supporting me right from my childhood, for saying all those nice things that you say whenever I put out a song and whenever I, perform live. So these are the kind of things that for artists like me, is very, very rewarding, and it really pushes us to put out quality content for you guys. So thank you so much for that. In terms of giving a message, I don't know, I guess I can just talk about things that I like to live by, and that is, whatever you do, do it with your full heart and your full passion and give it your best. Don't go into doing something half-heartedly. And whenever you're putting your efforts into something, don't really think about what the outcome will be like, what will be the reward, what will be the effect. Just focus on doing it to the best of your ability so that when you go to bed at night, you're really happy and you gave it your all. So that is something that I always live by. And in terms of, talking about giving a message to the youth of today, I think what has happened is when we go online on social media, of course, we all know this is such an age of social media, especially in the lockdown, all of us have been like glued to social media, right? And it's very easy in today's day and age to look at someone else's real life and feel insecure and feel like, you're not good enough. But I think the only competition at the end of the day is you, yourself. And you should every day work towards doing things that make you and your life better. And that will be the most fulfilling thing in the world. So these are just the two things that I like to live by and that I'm sharing it out with everybody.
Which I think is amazing. And thank you so much once again for taking time off and talking to us. It was amazing.
Thank you so
much
for having me.
Having you here.
It's fun.
Well, on that note, we come to an end of this episode of Gems of Goa. We'll bring to you some more gems of the soil, some more gems which have been created by this Goan soil. So for that, you need to keep watching your favorite channel, Prime. Keep watching Prime. नमस्कार प्राईम टीव्हीच्या कोकणी खबरापत्रांत तुमका सगळ्यांक हिनाचो माय मोगाचो येवकार. सुरवेक पळोवया आयच्यो मुखेल खबरो. गोय मुक्तीचे हिरक महोत्सवी वर्ष मनोवपाक केंद्रा कडल्यान 300 कोटीची खास पॅकेज. केंद्रीय अर्थमंत्री निर्मला सीतारामन हांणी अर्थसंकल्पान केली घोषणा. म्हादयचे रक्षण करूंक सरकार पुरायपणान फेल जाला. सरकारान जबाबदारी घेवन राजीनामो दिवचो. विरोधी पक्ष फुडारी दिगंबर कामत हांची मागणी.
2022 विधानसभा निवडणुकेचे फाटभुयेर पक्षाक घटमूट करपाची सल्ला तयारी. म्हादयच्या एकाच प्रश्नार गोयचे सगळे लोक काँग्रेस पक्षा वांगडा रावतले. काँग्रेसीचे रमाकांत खलप उलयले. आता खबरो विस्तारान. केंद्रीय अर्थमंत्री निर्मला सीतारामन हिणे लोकसभेन अर्थसंकल्प सादर केलो. सादर केल्ल्या अर्थसंकल्प प्रमाण कोविड लसीकरणा खातीर 35,000 कोटीची तरतूद केल्या. विमो कायद्यान सुदारणा जातली. BPCL विकतले. LIC IPO येतलो. सरकार एअर इंडिया विकतले. उज्ज्वला येवजणेन आनीक 1 कोटी लोकांचो आस्पाव करतले. शेतकारांक 1.5 पट उत्पादन खर्चाचो MSP दितले. एक राष्ट्र एक रेशन कार्डा अंतर्गत देशांत आता 1 रेशन कार्ड. जमनीची कागदपत्रां डिजिटल जातली. बायलांक रातपाळयेंत काम करपाची मेकळीक मेळटली. देशांत 900 सैनीक स्कुलां सुरू करतले. देशांत 15,000 परस चड आदर्श शाळा आसा. गोंय मुक्तीचे हिरक महोत्सवी वर्स मनोवपाक केंद्रा कडल्यान 300 कोटीची खास पॅकेज केंद्रीय अर्थमंत्री निर्मला सीतारामन हांणी अर्थसंकल्पान केली घोशणा. गोंय राज्याचे मुख्यमंत्री प्रमोद सावंत हांणी अर्थसंकल्पान येवकार दिला. हो अर्थसंकल्प सामान्य खातीर न्हय, वेस्ट बेंगॉल, तामिळनाडू आनी केरळा ह्या राज्यातल्या निवडणुको दोळ्या मुखार दवरून सादर केल्लो अर्थसंकल्प आसा म्हणून विरोधी पक्ष फुडारी दिगंबर कामत उलयले.
मॅडम निर्मला सीतारामन हांच्यानी केंद्रातलो बजेट मांडलो आनी तो बजेट पुराय देशाक म्हणजे सुखद धक्को दिवपी बजेट आशिल्लो. सगळ्यात पहिल्यात पहिली गोंयकारा खातीर सगळ्यांक सामकी गौरवाची गजाल आशिल्ली तिच्या ओपनिंग रिमार्क्सान. बजेटाच्या ओपनिंग रिमार्क्सान पहिलेच फावटी 60th year सेलिब्रेशन हाजो उल्लेख आशिल्लो आनी तातूंत स्पेशल मेन्शनान गोंयच्या 60 वर्सांच्या मुक्ती संग्रामाचेर म्हणजे हे मनयता आनी तेजी कॉग्निझन्स गव्हर्मेंट ऑफ इंडियात घेतलो हाजे खातीर हांव पंतप्रधान नरेंद्र मोदीजी, अमित जी शाह, निर्मला सीतारामन हांचे खूब खूब आभारी आसा. दुसरी गजाल हे सेलिब्रेशन करपा खातीर तांच्यांनी आमकां 300 crores ऑफ रुपीज फ्रॉम द गव्हर्मेंट ऑफ इंडिया ह्या पुराय वर्सभरा खातीर विविध प्रकल्प मागीर ते इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलॉपमेंटचेर आसुनी ह्युमन डेवलॉपमेंटचेर आसुनी किंवां स्वतंत्र संग्रामांत ती विविध स्थळां आसुनी हाजेर डिसायड करपाचें आसा. हांवें जेन्ना ठरयल्लें किंवां 60th year सेलिब्रेशन करप तेन्ना ताजी कमिटी कॉन्स्टिट्यूट केल्ली आनी कमिटी कॉन्स्टिट्यूट करता आसतना सगळ्यां कडल्यान आमी विविध योजनाय मागयल्ल्यो कितें करपाचें. आमी म्हटलेलें की आमी 100 crores ऑफ रुपीज केंद्रा कडल्यान मागयला ताज्या खातीर आमी प्लॅनूय करता आनी विविध गजाली आमी प्लॅन केल्ल्यो. म्हाका निश्चितच दिसता की फुडल्या वर्सभराच्या भितर आमी दोनूय गजाली ज्यो मुक्ती संग्रामांक रिलेटेड आसा तेजी वेगवेगळ्या जाग्या वयली इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर्स आसतली किंवां वेगवेगळ्या ग्रामपंचायतीच्या क्षेत्रांत म्हणजे आमी जशें बजेट आत्मनिर्भर भारत हें बजेट आसा त्या धर्तीचेर आमी स्वयंपूर्ण गोवा हो कन्सेप्ट सगळे लोकां पर्यंत व्हरपाक केला. त्या खातीर 60 वर्सां मुक्ती संग्रामाची मनयता आसतना निश्चितच स्वयंपूर्ण गोंय करपा खातीर आमकां आनिकूय बी खूब मोठी बूस्ट जी आसा ही बजेटांत दिल्ली आसा.
हे बजेट सामान्य मनशा खातीर न्ही, हे बजेट आसा ते फक्त वेस्ट बंगाल, तामिळनाडू, केरळा ही 3 राज्यांची इलेक्शनां दोळे मुखार दवरून प्रेझेंट केल्ले बजेट आसा. खरं म्हणजे कोविड पॅन्डेमिकांतल्यान देश गेला, ह्या देशाची गरीब जनता त्रासांत आसा, ह्या देशाचे लेबर्स आज त्रासांत आसा, ह्या देशातली MSME आज त्रासांत आसा. पूण तांचे खातीर लेबर एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेट करपा खातीर किंवा जे एम्प्लॉयमेंटातल्यान त्रासा पडिल्ले आसा तांचे रिजनरेशन एम्प्लॉयमेंट करपा खातीर कसल्योच स्किमी ह्या बजेटांत दिसना. ह्या बजेटांत सामान्य मनशा खातीर कांयच ना. हे बजेट आसा ते फक्त फार्सिकल बजेट आसा. म्हणजे एका वटेन आमी म्हणटात की बारीक मनशां खातीर डिक्लेअर करपाक जाय, गरिबांक आदार करपाक जाय. ह्या कोवीड पॅन्डेमिकल्यान जर खरो कोण हादरला, कोणा जर त्रासांत पडला तो सामान्य मनीस, बारीक मनीस. आनी म्हणून म्हाका दिसता ह्या बजेटांतल्यान कसलोच दिलासो ह्या बारीक मनशाक दिल्लो ना. ह्या बजेटांतल्यान कसलोच दिलासो MSMEक दिलो ना. किंबहुना हांव पळयतालो की बजेट एस्टिमेटांत सेंट्रल टॅक्सीचो शेअर 2,400 कोटी आशिल्लो दाखयताले. आतां पळयलें जाल्यार तो सेंट्रल टॅक्सीचो शेअर 300 कोटींनी देंवला, 200 कोटी 2,100 कोटी दाखयला.
हांवें आयकल्लें की सरकार 100 crores मागल्या म्हणून आनी 300 crores दिल्या. इट्स अ बोनांझा. इतलो जर बोनांझा मेळ्ळा तर लेट्स सी हाव गोवा गव्हर्मेंट तो उजार करतलो. तो गोव्यान आज इतकी बेकारी जाली आज बेस्ट सेलेब्रेशन करून जर 300 crores आमी जर काबार करतले आय एम नॉट फॉर इट वी आर नॉट फॉर इट कंस्ट्रक्टीव काम जावपाक जाय गव्हर्मेंट ऑफ इंडिया कडेन जर 300 crores जर मेळ्ळ्यात कंस्ट्रक्टीव काम जावपाक जाय एक पर्मनंट इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर जातले भितर उबें जावपाक जाय दुसरें फ्रिडम फायटरान जें आमकां काम केलें ते भुरगे थंय काल पयर पर्यंत बसल्यात हांगा उपोशणाक बसल्यात हंगर स्ट्रायकचे बसल्यात तेंचे प्रश्न सोडपाक जाय आनी गोंयांत ह्या 300 croresचो उपयोग फेस्तां करपाक उपयोग पडना आमकां फेस्त सदांच आमी करतात दॅट मनी मस्ट बी यूज फॉर सम काँक्रीट वर्क आणि हे कसे स्पेंड करचे ते ठरवपाक बरे म्हणजे ऑल पार्टी एक मीट जावपाक जाय
नाव दॅट इज अ पॉझिटिव्ह थिंग फॉर वर्क बिकॉज यू नो our collections were less and we were depending upon a lot of borrowings but with this with this impetus of 300 crores that has been granted by the government as we enter the 60th year after liberation this will help a lot in meeting the deficits that we are facing today
About the mining sector
no there was nothing said about mining in this budget there's nothing for mining but I think if we read the finance bill probably there might be something in it and we have to see this in details you know we've heard the speech right now we know the general idea of what the budget is about and what shape of the things to come but there are a lot of details that will come out now we'll have to go through those to find out specifics
I've said all the positive things that are there about the budget so coming tourism industry as such has been the worst hit with COVID in Goa itself I think only 25% of the registered hotels are open Mr. Deep Kalrao was on record in the Economic Times saying yesterday that tourism, even domestic tourism is at 50% of what it normally is and international tourism is basically nil, there's nothing happening. So considering that tourism as per Economic Times figures yesterday has an employment of around 80 million before COVID and considering the severe stress that it has gone through I think the tourism industry expected quite a bit more from the budget thinking that the government has a Dekho Apna Desh scheme wherein it's been marketing the entire country non-stop but there has been no incentive given to any consumer to travel perhaps they could have done some sort of tax incentive they could have rebate to travel in Goa we have the industry status so I think we are okay with the hotel but across the country I think one of the demands was that hotels all over should have been given industry status that has not been considered at all so overall the number of good things in the budget the fact that faceless assessments you have to assessments cannot be opened beyond 3 years ease of doing business But coming specifically to travel and tourism, there's nothing, absolutely nothing in the budget for it.
It is being a very positive budget, I would say. Because we were under fear that, Bhandari also said, that there could be any increase in the direct taxes, which has not happened. And if you see the overall budget, there is a lot of infrastructural expenses that government is talking about. Now, as far as health is concerned, almost 13% of GDP has been allocated for the health sector. Lot of financial manufacturing sector, almost 1.97 lakh crore has been allocated. Highways is, I think, maximum 5.5 lakh crore. Now, all this expenditure, what has been planned, which will certainly boost up the employment as well as the MSMEs and other inflow in the system. Which will help the economy to grow higher. Specifically, I would like to talk about the MSME. She spoke about the labor codes which has been implemented. Minimum wages has been, you know, kept for the all categories of the workmen. Especially night shift for women, they are talking about allowing. And in Goa, we find that women you know, employment is increasing in pharma and other sectors also. This is a very welcome sign. FDI investment from 49 has been increased to 74. So that will also boost up the economy. Education also, they have given lot of additional this thing. And the income tax, what returns and all, initially it was 6 years we had to keep the books and all, that they have reduced to 3 years. In short, what they have done is more or less they have catered to all the sectors of the industries and all part of the
ब्युरो रिपोर्ट प्राइम.
म्हादय निवाड्याच्या अधिसुचोवणेक विरोध न करपाची सुचोवणी सरकारान कोणाकूच दिवंक ना. शासकीय सुचोवण्यो सदांच लेखी आसतात म्हूण मुख्यमंत्री सांगता, मात ही केस लडोवपी सिनियर काउन्सील भलतेच सांगता म्हूण मडगांवचे आमदार विरोधी पक्ष फुडारी दिगंबर कामत उलयले. ह्या सगळ्याची सरकारान जबाबदारी घेवन राजिनामो दिवचो अशी मागणी दिगंबर कामत हांणी मुखार केल्या. म्हादयचे रक्षण करूंक सरकार पुरायपणान फेल जाला अशें ते मुखार उलयले.
आज म्हादयची केज गोंय सरकाराच्या वतीन जो सिनियर काउन्सील लढयतालो तो सिनियर काउन्सील एडवोकेट दातार हाणें जो आज स्टेटमेंट केला तो खरेंच सामको धक्कादायक आसा. आपल्या स्टेटमेंटांत तो म्हणटा की आपल्याक सरकाराचे इन्स्ट्रक्शन्स आशिल्ले की ऑब्जेक्ट करनाका म्हणून, जेन्ना कर्नाटकाचे पिटिशन फॉर नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ म्हादय ट्रिब्युनल अवॉर्ड वॉज टेकन अप फॉर हियरींग इन द सुप्रीम कोर्ट, हाजेर आमचे विरोधी पक्षाचे आमदाराचे कॉलिंग अटेंशन आशिल्ले. आमी एक कॉलिंग अटेंशन दिल्ले म्हादय अवॉर्डाचेर डिस्कस करपाक आनी ते आयले. सरकारान एडमीट केले, सभापतीन ते एडमीट केले आनी ते डिस्कशनाक गेले. त्या वेळाचेर गव्हर्मेंटाचे वतीन कॅटेगरिकली आमकां सांगले गेले की लॉयरान जे डिसिजन कोर्टान घेतले ऑब्जेक्ट न करपाचे हे प्युअरली ताजे डिसिजन आशिल्ले. गव्हर्मेंटा कडल्यान ताका कांयच इन्स्ट्रक्शन्स नाशिल्ली किंवा गव्हर्मेंटा कडेन ताणें डिस्कस करूं ना आनी ऑन द स्पॉट ताणें तें डिसिजन घेतलें असो स्टेटमेंट आमकां सरकाराचे वतीन थंय केलो गेलो. पण आज जेन्ना ह्या सिनियर काउन्सिलाचें क्लॅरिफिकेशन येलें तें पळयतकीर अशें दिसलें की हे सगळें ठरोवन केलां काय कितें. कारण ताणें एक पॉयंट रेज केला तो सामको वॅलीड आसा. तो सिनियर काउन्सील म्हणटा की आपणे जर सरकाराचे इन्स्ट्रक्शन्स नासतना जर आपणे थंय आपूण उगी राविलो, आपणे जर ऑब्जेक्शन रेज केले नाशिल्ले जाल्यार गोवा गव्हर्मेंटान इमिजिएटली परत एप्लिकेशन करपाचे, दॅट इट शूड बी हर्ड म्हणून. तशें एप्लिकेशन ताणें कांयच केले ना अशें आज ताजो एक स्टेटमेंट आयला. म्हाका दिसता हाजेर सरकारान पूर्णपणे जबाबदारी घेवपाची गरज आसा. कारण एक म्हणजे विधानसभेत खरी माहिती दिवप ना आणि दुसरे आज सिनियर काउन्सिल जे सांगता ते वेगळेच असा. हाजेर सरकारान जबाबदारी घेऊन, हांवें काल सांगले की सरकारान जबाबदारी घेऊन राजीनामा दिवचो. कारण हो प्रश्न अत्यंत जिवाळ्याचो सगळ्या गोयकारांचो. म्हादय ही आमची सगळ्यांची आवय असे सगळे जाण म्हणतात. दिवची ना रे दिवची ना, आमची म्हादय दिवची ना असे स्लोगन अख्ख्या गोयात लोकांनी ऐकला. आणि म्हणून म्हाका दिसता हे सरकाराचे कर्तव्य आशिले की म्हादयचे रक्षण कर, ते रक्षण करपाक हे सरकार फेल झालं.
ब्युरो रिपोर्ट.
आता घेऊया एक व्यावसायिक विसव. Kandolim Deck. Come dine with us and enjoy Goa's best hospitality service. Enjoy a very delicious cuisine, North Indian, Goan, Continental, Chinese, you name it and we have it all. Visit us at Wadi Sikeri Road, Kandolim, Goa.
Contact 247-9040 or 9822-580138.
विसाउपरांत परतून एक फाट येवकार आता पळोवया फुडल्यो खबरो. 2022 निवडणुको मतीन दवरून गोंय प्रदेश काँग्रेस समितीन पक्षाक आनीक चड घट करपाचें काम सुरू केलां. 40 मतदारसंघांनी आमचे समन्वयक थारिल्ले आसात आनी हे समन्वयक दर एका मतदारसंघांनी भोंवून आमची संघटना मजबूत करतले अशी म्हायती काँग्रेसीचे समन्वयक समितीचे संयोजक रमाकांत खलप हांणी म्हळां. म्हादयच्या एकाच प्रश्नार गोंयचे सगळे लोक काँग्रेस पक्षा वांगडा रावतले अशें रमाकांत खलप हांणी मुखार सांगलें. सोमारा जाल्ले बसके वेळार आमी 2 महिन्याचो प्रोग्राम तयार केला. 6 तारखेक आमची आनीक एक बसका घेतले अशी म्हायती तांणी मुखार दिली.
डिस्कशनान आमी एक 2 महिन्याचो प्रोग्राम मोरलेस आमी फायनलायज केला. ऑफकोर्स दीस इज स्टील इन द ड्राफ्ट फॉर्म. आमी हो प्रोग्राम आमचो काडटले आनी आमचो जो चीफ कोऑर्डिनेटर आसा इनचार्ज गोवा डॅस्क मिस्टर दिनेश गुंडूराव तो फाल्यां 5 तारखेचो येतलो आनी 6 तारखेचा सगळ्यांची मिटींग जातली. सो ते राती कडेन बसून आमी हो सगळो फायनलायज करून एनावन सारको प्रोग्राम करतले ऑन 6th. सो ऑन 6th परतून एकदां कॉर्डिनेशन कमिटीची मिटींग जातली. त्या मिटींगेन गोवा डॅस्क इनचार्ज म्हणून दिनेश गुंडूराव आसतलो. नंबर 2 नॉर्थ गोवाचो ऑब्जर्वर आसा तो आसतलो. साउथ गोवाचो ऑब्जर्वर आसतलो आनी एन्टायर गोवा ऑब्जर्वर आसतले. अशे 3 ऑब्जर्वर आमकां EICCन आमकां दिल्ले आसात. ते 3 कोण प्रकाश राठोड म्हणटा तो ऑब्जर्वर फॉर गोवा आसा. नॉर्थ गोवाक ऑब्जर्वर आसा मनसूर खान आनी साउथ गोवाक आसा सुनील हनुमन्नवार. हे तिगूय आसतले. ही कमिटी आसतली आनी त्या कमिटीन मिटींग जावन आमी सगळो प्रोग्राम फायनलायज करतले. म्हाका सांगपाक बरी खोशी जाता की आज जे आमचे कॉर्डिनेशन कमिटीचे मेंबर हांगा जमले ते एका बरे नवे उमेदीन आयले आसा सगळे आनी सगळ्यांनी पार्टिसिपेट केलें डिस्कशनाक आनी ऑल गोवा स्प्रेड आवट जावन आमी काम करुया अशें आमचें थारलां. तर डिस्ट्रीक्ट कप आमची गोवा ही कॉर्डिनेशन कमिटी मेन कॉर्डिनेशन कमिटी आमची PCCचे मेंबर सगळे डिस्ट्रीक्ट कमिटीचे मेंबर हे सगळे वील फॅन आवट इन द होल स्टेट ऑफ गोवा. आमी कॉन्स्टिट्युएंसी वांटून घेतल्यात. कोणाक म्हणजे कॉन्स्टिट्युएंसी कितें ती. सो 40 कॉन्स्टिट्युएंसीज देर वील बी 40 ग्रुप्स वर्कींग कन्सोलिडेशन ऑफ पार्टी. आमकां मँडेट दिल्या ती रिकन्स्ट्रक्शन करपाक जाय आमकां. सो ब्लॉक रिकन्स्ट्रक्ट जातलो मागीर डिस्ट्रिक्ट कमिटी रिस्ट्रक्ट जातली PCC रिस्ट्रक्टर जातली. हे रिकन्स्ट्रक्शन करता आसतना गांवांत गेल्याशिवाय आमकां जायना काम करपाक. म्हणून आमी थारायलां तें अशें की आमी कामेस काम कॉमेस काम करचें तें फ्रॉम ग्रावंड लेवल करया.
See, we are working in a direction which we are looking after the interest of the party. So I think it is a good thing, and let it move. Let us see, Kaldugar. So there is no question of happy. The question is the party has to win, and before the party has to win, there has to be some work to be done, which we are doing. And in the interest of how to, you know, win the trust of the people, how to work, how everything will be discussed and taken.
You and Kalapara also looking at that zeal which was not there earlier in this, your workers, your party.
Yeah, we are working on that. That requires a boost, otherwise it will have no impact otherwise.
Once your report and everything comes, it will be automatically, this will move ahead and help you all as far as assembly elections are
concerned.
Yes, yes, yes. So, first,
sorry?
How you all are looking at that, those things? Because everything you all have to put in place now.
See, the responsibility is big. So, let us not, we'll cross the bridge when we reach the bridge. But let us, one thing is sure, we are serious in what we are doing, and we look towards success in whatever we do.
Yeah, so the process and constituency level, like the leaders go into the whole election, I think find out that the potential are this is going to be.
So, again, to some point, to
not point to the which are still not done.
That is part of the process.
Part of the process.
प्रायमा खातीर चलचित्र पत्रकार विलियम रॉड्रिक्स पणजी.
सरकाराच्यो येवजण्यो आपणाल्या मतदारसंघातल्या लोकां मेरेन पावून तांकां ह्या येवजण्यांचो लाभ मेळोवन दिवपाचें काम सगळे आमदार करतात. मांद्रे मतदारसंघाचें प्रतिनिधित्व करता आसतना 40 मतदारसंघां मदीं मांद्रे मतदारसंघान चडांत चड कामां केल्यात आनी मंत्री मायकल लुबो फाटल्यान आपणालो नंबर लागता अशें मांद्रेचे आमदार दयानंद सोपटे हांणी सांगले. आपल्या मतदारसंघातल्या लोकांक सिनियर सिटीजन कार्डां वाटले उपरांत ते उलयताले. ह्या कार्डाचेर म्हज्या वाठारांतल्या वरिश्ठ नागरिकांक प्रवास करतना खूब उपेगी थारतली अशें ते मुखार उलयले.
सगळ्यापेक्षा जास्त सगळ्यो स्किमी सिनियर सिटीजन असो डीएसएस असो लाडली लक्ष्मी असो किंवा गृह आधार असो हांव आनी म्हाजे जे स्टाफ आसात आनी कार्यकर्ते आसात बरें काम करतात म्हणूनच खंय तरी आज नांव घेतात की दयानंद सोपटे एमंग 40 नंबर 2 आमदार म्हाजे पयली मिनिस्टर आहात काम करता हे सगळे घटकात तुमचे वर्षी सहकार्य मेळटा ज्या ज्या गांवांनी म्हजे कार्यकर्ते ते कार्यकर्ते बरे काम करतात हांव तुमचे रिजन मागता अशेंच तुमचे सहभाग सहकार्याची गरज आसा आजशी आणि आज हे कार्ड दिला त्याचे मेन बेनिफिट म्हणजे सिनियर सिटीजन म्हणजे एक तुमकां आयडेंटिटी जेचो एक खंय तरी प्रवास करतना प्रामुख्यान कदंबा ट्रान्सपोर्ट कॉर्पोरेशनच्यो बसी ज्यो आसात गव्हर्मेंटाच्यो तेतून तुमकां 50% तिकेट तरी बाकीच्या समज 10 रुपये जर आसले जाल्यार तुमकां 5 रुपयांनी हांगाच्यान समजा मारसा 50% अर्धे तिकेटीन पावूंक शकता. रेल्वेन प्रवासाचो रेल्वेन तुमकां बेनिफीट मेळटा 50%. तेतून जर तुम बँक नॅशनलायज ज्यो बँक आमचे आसात म्हणजे नॅशनल म्हणजे राष्ट्रीयकृत बँक नॅशनल म्हणजे स्टेट बँक असो कॅनरा बँक असो सेंट्रल बँक असो कॉर्पोरेशन बँक असो ह्या वेगवेगळ्या बँकेनी तुमचे खातीर ज्यो तुम्ही डिपॉझिट दवरतात बाकीच्या परस 1% तुमकां व्याज मार्च आसा आणि ह्या जाग्यार तुम्ही जर लोन काढलो जाल्यार बाकीच्या परस 1 रुपये म्हणजे 1% इंटरेस्ट कमी म्हणजे दवरतात तुमचे पैशाचेर 1% जास्त आणि जर लोन काढलो जाल्यार बाकीच्या परस 1% कमी व्याज.
प्रायमा खातीर चलचित्र पत्रकार प्रसाद पोळजी पेडणे.
आता घेऊया एक व्यावसायिक विसव.
The Baga Deck. Lies in the comfort with unmatched luxury. The bluest of skies melt seamlessly into the azure of the Arabian Sea to make a picture-perfect backdrop to a unique, tailor-made tropical holiday experience. Come join us at the Baga Deck Comforts, Cobra Wado, opposite Subway, Kalangut Baga Road, Kalangut Bades, Goa. For details, contact
सोप्रान परतून एक फाट येवकार आतां पळोवया फुडल्यो खबरो. कळंगूटचे आमदार मंत्री मायकल लोबो हांणी आपणाल्या मतदारसंघांत दिल्ली बिल्डर माफिया प्रोत्साहन दिता असो आरोप कळंगूटचे आदले आमदार आग्नेल फर्नांडीस हांणी केला. कळंगूटांत थळाव्या लोकांक बिल्डरा कडल्यान सतावणूक जाता आनी ह्या सगळ्याक खुद्द कळंगूटचे आमदार मंत्री मायकल लोबो जापसालदार आसा असो आरोपय तांणी मुखार केला. कळंगूटचे PI ह्या सगळ्या कारस्थानांत तितलोच वांटेकार आसा अशें म्हणी तांणी कळंगूटे PI रोपोस हांचेर ताशेरे ओडले. PI रोपोसाक लागून कळंगूटास बेकायदेशीर वेवसायाक चालना मेळटा आनी पुलिसांक हप्तो मेळटा अशें तांणी मुखार म्हळां.
मायकल लोबोन आमचे कळंगूटे MLA आनी मिनिस्टर हेज फॉर्म्ड ए दिल्ली बिल्डर्स माफिया इन आवर कॉन्स्टिट्युएंसी. नाउ लेट हिम से कॅटेगरिकली, let him be very clear whether he has approached these people to compromise with the builder. Tu to tel sangdalo ki apan goyekaraje sidek ravtalo mhanun tu tar goyekaraje sidek ravtay jale ya bailanchin kida compromise karu tu builder ang samjay baba inje jago di an magere karu mhanun. Same case is going to happen now in Agarwado in Kalangut. There is a lady called Lutz. Now Michael has been sending people to her, sending panchayat members to her. He has approached her, builder action compromise karu mhanun. And these builders have now issued a notice to her. She's already declared a munkar. She has put an application for purchase. The builders are harassing her. He is sending his people. He is approaching them. Tumhi bahar sara mhanun. The lady doesn't want to get out from there. Orhile kesi Kalangut kandulin jayat aha. And Michael is responsible for this. He has sagale PDA korun, he korun jene pe builder ang adlya koyen. Especially Kalangut. He is encouraging these builders to forcibly evict our locals. मायकलाचं वाद नसताना बायले गुंडा येऊन हांगा आमच्या बायलांची रात घाली ना. आयज त्यो दोगी बायलो हितून आहा, जेलीन आहा, आमकां बाजून बेल जावंक नासली तेंची. टू आर द लेडीज आर स्कॉन्डींग, दे हॅव बीन थ्रेटन दॅट दे विल बी इन जेल. लायक द लेडीज हॅव सेड, बायलांक मारले हेंच्यांनी, बायलो पुलिशेन भायर भायर आहा टू बी अरेस्टीड, आनी हो कोणें मारला पळय तो भितर पी आय बरें आसलो. आय हॅव ऑलवेज बीन सेईंग दीस पी आय इज सो करप्ट, आय हॅव बीन सेईंग इट टायम एंड अगेन. हो बिल्डरा बरोबर सगळें हें आसा. रापोज इज द मोस्ट करप्ट पुलीस ऑफिसर दॅट वी हॅव गट. आयज बायलांक अरेस्ट केल्या, दुसऱ्या बायलांक अरेस्ट करूंक सोदता ओन्ली अंडर द इंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ मायकल लोबो. आनी मायकल लोबोन ताका दवरला इतलेंच काम करपाक. ही सेकेंड हफ्ता फ्रॉम प्रोस्टिट्यूट, आय हॅव ऑलवेज मेंटेन दॅट. अँड नाव ही सेकेंड हफ्ता फ्रॉम दीस दिल्ली बिल्डर्स. आनी दे अनलिस्ट अ रेन ऑफ टेरर ऑन मुनकाज अँड टेनंट्स इन द कालांगूट कॉन्स्टिट्युएंसी. ही इज कंडेमिंग, ही डीड कंडेमनेशन फॉर सोजा लोबोज ऑल्सो. सोजा लोबोज ऑल्सो भायले गुंड कशें येता. सी गोंयान बारीक नेबरांची झगडी जाताली आदी फॉर प्रॉपर्टी. हे भायले गुंड कशें येता गोंयान, सोजा लोबोज द आवटसायडर्स. दीस एस्टडे कांदोलीम वॉज आवटसायडर्स एन्ड द सेम केस इज गोंट हॅपन इन आगारवाडो.
प्रायमा खातीर चलचित्र पत्रकार विलियम रॉड्रिक्स, पणजी.
मरीना प्रकल्प रद्द करता म्हूण जो मेरेन सरकार आमकां लेखी आश्वासन दिना तो मेरेन मरीना आडचे आमचे झूज आमी चालूच दवरतले, अशी शिटकावणी गोवन्स अगेन्स्ट मरीना प्रकल्प संघटनेन दिल्या. आमी आमदार सिल्वेरा हांच्या सगळ्या कार्यावळीचेर बहिष्कार घालतले. सरकारान म्हयन्या भितर हाचेर योग्य निर्णय घेतलो ना जाल्यार मार्चाच्या 1 तारखेच्यान आमी बांबोळे बंद करून दाखयतले, आमी रस्तो वाडयतले आनी कोणाकूच ह्या वाठारांत घेवचे नात, अशी शिटकावणी संघटनेन मुखार दिल्या.
पयर सरप्रायजींग जालें पयर आमचे हियरींग आले हायकोर्टान, जेन्ना आमचे 27th म्हजे अगेन्स्ट पिटिशन घेतले, म्हाका रिस्पोंडंट केले. सो ताणें कितें म्हटलें की जो आमचो गव्हर्नमेंट एडवोकेट आसा, एडवोकेट जनरल आमचो आसा, ताणें म्हटलें स्टेटमेंट केलें की अशें आपल्याक कांयच अजून पासून सीएमान कोणी सांगूंक ना म्हणून. आमकां खूब वायट दिसलें जेन्ना सीएम जेन्ना स्टेटमेंट रिस्पोन्सिबल पर्सन गोंयचो तो हेड जावन आसा आनी तूं जेन्ना स्टेटमेंट करता आनी की हो आपल्याक प्रोजेक्ट आपूण स्क्रॅप करतलो म्हणून आनी तूं तुज्या एजीक इनफॉर्मेशन दिना, इट इज दीस इज टोटली म्हाका दिसता हें खंय तरी आयदर एक सीएम आमचे कडेन हेळटा काय एजीक हेळटा कांय सजमना. कित्याक सीएम असो केन्नाच स्टेटमेंट करूंक शकना की जो इंस्ट्रक्शन एजीक दिना तशें पळय. कित्याक तुमी जाणा एजी म्हणजे गोंयचो आमचो तो हेजो एज फार एज लिगल इज कन्सर्न एवरीथींग द गव्हर्नमेंट हॅज टू रिपोर्ट टू हीम. आनी आयज पासून परतून एजीचो स्टेटमेंट ना आनी सीएमाचो परतून कांय स्टेटमेंट ना. आतां सीएमाक हांवें हें सांगता की अपील करता की एटलिस्ट तूं ओपन फोरमाचेर सांग की खऱ्यांनी तुवें तो स्टेटमेंट केल्लो, तो खऱ्यांनी केल्लो काय, बेश्टो आमकां फटींगपणान केल्लो काय म्हणून. बेजिकली आजचे जे आमी प्रेस कॉन्फरन्स आयज मागले एकाच कारणाक लागून, तुमी जाण आसतले आमी आतां कितलो एक मोर देन 2 वर्सां जालीं 2018 आमी झगडटा की हो मरीना प्रोजेक्ट जो नावशी येवपाक जो प्रपोज केल्लो ताचेर तो प्रोजेक्ट नाका म्हणून आमी आतां इतलो टायम जालो आमी झगडटा. बेजिकली फ्रॉम 2010 आमी झगडटा हे प्रोजेक्ट. आतां सेफ आवट हे आमचो लढो चालू आसा आनी तो आतां कोर्टानूय पावलो आसा. कित्याक ही कंपनीन जेवण झगडटा की आपल्याक प्रोजेक्ट नाका म्हणून आपण जायतेच फावट डेलिगेशन घेवन हांगा गेलो सीएमा कडेन. आनी वय खरेंच आमी गेल्लो तेज्या वांगडा, पयले 2-3 फावट आमी गेल्ले, मागीर तेणी आख्खे म्हाका दिसता सगळे पंचाकूय घेवन गेल्लो तो आनी ताकाय पॉझिटीव रिस्पॉन्स दिलो सीएमान, आपूण हो प्रोजेक्ट स्क्रॅप करतलो म्हणून. जेन्ना पयर सरप्रायजींग जालें ज्या दिसा पयर आमचे हियरींग आलें हायकोर्टान, जेन्ना आमचे 27th की हांव म्हजे अगेन्स्ट तेणी पिटिशन घेतलें, जें म्हाका तेगे रिस्पोंडंट केलें. सो ताणें कितें म्हटलें की जो आमचो गव्हर्नमेंट एडवोकेट आसा, एडवोकेट जनरल आमचो आसा, ताणें म्हटलें स्टेटमेंट केलें की